Hey everybody, Jay, Krista, Sadie Forever coming at you, Book Friday, and this is going to be a hot one.
It's about love.
Love.
It's about waffles and spaghetti making love.
That's no, right. Censored.
Censored. We are doing the book, Men Are Like Waffles, Women Are Like Spaghetti from Bill and Pam Farrell. And I told you guys this book is hilarious and a little steamy. Yep. And this Friday we are on chapter 4. It's Waffles and Spaghetti in Love, Preparing for the Main Course. And
that's right.
We're going to leave it up to you guys to read the first section on your own when children are not around. It's a little... It's a little steamy.
It's definitely PG-13. Just saying.
So hot. So what is your romantic style? What is your spouse's romantic style? Are you a romantic? Do you know what your spouse loves in romance? This chapter is all about that. And by the way, tonight, Jay and I are going to go to a wedding, and I talked him into wearing his suit with a tie, cologne.
She likes me dressed up, so now I get the point of why she's always dragging me to weddings.
It's the only time I can get you.
Because I dress up at going to a wedding, so it is what it is.
It's my love language.
That's right.
Yeah. So, like I said, we're going to leave it up to you to be reading most of the stuff.
In the beginning.
What the gal does, Pam does for Bill is, woo, hot and steamy. Shows up in his hotel room. You got to read that yourself. So, pretty much it's talking about all the different types of romance. And this chapter is packed full of ideas. Ways you can romance your spouse. Maybe you feel a little fuddy-dud. Maybe you're newlyweds and you already got this going, but eventually you're going to need this chapter.
Yeah.
We're oldie-weds, and sometimes the romance gets a little fizzled out, and so we need to be reminded to romance each other.
Yeah, and don't get us wrong. I mean, it doesn't have to be that way. We are right in the middle of some pretty important stuff going on in our lives right now. So
romance takes a...
It kind of gets put on the back burner.
Unless we get invited to a wedding.
Correct.
And then we're out on the town. So the really cool thing about this chapter is it has some fun parts. And so on page 71, it actually starts a series of 4 types of lover. So go get your spouse, bring them here, and let's see what your type is and what your spouse's type is. And of course, Jay and I, we are reading this cold turkey. We decided a lot of this stuff we are not reading ahead of time because I just want to see our reactions.
This should be really good.
So there's 4 types of lovers.
Okay.
And they are, these are their characteristics and their preference of romance. So listen to type number 1 and see if this is you or your spouse. See if it's you or me.
Okay, go for it.
Okay, the knight in shiny armor or the queen of hearts. Examples are Lancelot, James Bond, Robin Hood, Crocodile Dundee. Crocodile Dundee, really? Joan of Arc or Lois Lane. Okay, the characteristics are they're more dominant, task-oriented, I got that one, extroverted, no, loves new experiences, controlling, focused, active, cooperative, makes a decision and gets with it, conquering, and their preferences in romance, number 1, they're adventurous, they like adventurous activities. Number 2, Club Med. Number 3, no guided tours. Number 4, hiking. Number 5, anything they decide is a good idea. In other words, they're the ones in control. So their personality type is usually choleric, dominant, or the lion. And the lion's going to be in, who is that? Does that one? Gary Smalley?
Yep.
He does a different personality type. So that would be your lion. I had a few that I liked in there, but that didn't feel like me.
And that's the funny part. I used to be, that was my...
You were a lion?
Characteristic was lion, but I'm not anymore.
But you're half lion, half otter.
That is true.
So let's see.
That's the fun part.
Okay. Type 2. Let's see if you or your spouse or Jay or I are type 2 lovers. The hopeless romantic. Example is Anne of Avonlea. Obviously, I don't do a lot of reading. Cupid. That's very interesting. Cupid, I didn't even know. I knew he liked to make people in love, but I didn't know that he was actually a lover.
Yeah, that is strange.
Okay, characteristics for type 2. People-oriented, extroverted, is the center of attention, loves to be with lots of people, enjoys new experiences, fun, unique, exotic, ooh, daring, looks for new adventure, active. His preferences...
So I have a question. So, why is this a personality trait of what you are if they want to be around a lot of people? If I'm going to be romantic with my wife, I'm not going to be around a lot of people.
These are the characteristics of your personality.
Well, I'm not going to want to be around a lot of people.
Doesn't mean that you want to be around people for that.
No.
Okay. The preferences in romance. Number one, anything new. Entertainment that is personal and touches the heart. That's number two. Human drama, plays, musical, concerts. That's not you at all. Four, adventurous outings, exotic getaways. Anything sound good to you?
Yeah, some of those.
Well, that's interesting because this is... what is that word right there? The personality type is...
Inspirational otter.
And
sanguine?
Sanguine.
I don't even know what that is, but inspirational and otter, yeah.
Yeah, you're an otter.
So what is that? That's the hopeless romantic, yeah. I'll say that's where I fall into.
You're kind of a hopeless romantic.
Yep.
Okay.
Well, I was raised by my mother. I watched a lot of movies.
That's true. That is true.
I watched a lot of Hallmark movies growing up, and I watch a lot of Hallmark movies now.
Every day.
That's right. So why wouldn't I be a hopeless romantic?
Type 3 lover. The wind beneath my wings. Example, Superman, Robert and Elizabeth Browning. Characteristics, people-oriented, introverted, relaxed, easygoing. Well, we lost me on that one.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Wound up a little tight spring there. Not easygoing.
Wait, how about takes it as it comes?
No. No.
Stress-free.
Nope.
Has time to talk.
Yeah, well, you're retired now, so yeah.
Preferences in romance. A light schedule, simple activities, time to relax. I do like that.
Yeah.
I'd rather just have time to relax. Escape from reality, flexible. Entertainment, where there is plenty of time to enjoy it. So they just want to experience it.
Yeah, you like to just experience
it. Okay, so that...
What is that one?
Personality type.
Wind beneath my wings. Okay, so you got...
Phlegmatic, steady, and retriever.
Okay. Yeah, that's probably you.
Okay. Number 4.
What's 4?
Okay. The true blue lover. Okay. Romeo and Juliet is the example. Characteristic. Task-oriented. Introverted.
Oh, boy.
Predictable.
I could... Yeah. Looks like we have a winner.
Scheduled. Enjoys things that are significant.
Yep, you are all of those.
Preferences in romance. Guided tours. You know, they're not so much.
Guided tours would be you, though, because you like a structured situation, environment. You're very structured. You don't like to just, well, let's just go over here and we'll just go drive to this state and go look at their garden or whatever. You just, you're not like
that. And yet at certain times when we go on a drive, I'm like, go down that road. Go down that road. Let's go see what's over there.
Yeah, but if it's something that we're going to see that's truly important to you, you won't do a lot of go down that road, go down. You'll be on a mission to see what's...
But I get annoyed with guided tours because it's not my agenda. It's not my agenda. Okay.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. Number two. Educational outings. I do like to have a purpose. I think we should kill two birds with one stone. If we're going to be romantic, we might as well get something done while we're doing it. This is so bad. Oh. Museums.
Let's go to the Smithsonian. That's going to be really great. Maybe they'll have a guided tour.
Museums.
Oh, man.
I do like museums. Historical tours. That's kind of cool.
Oh, boy.
I want to go to Israel.
Oh, boy.
Long conversations.
That's her. That's her.
Okay. My personality type is melancholy, cautious, or beaver. And in the animal one from Gary Smalley, I have always scored very high in the beaver.
And I've,
it's the and one the who, they're yeah. building a dam.
Don't interrupt.
Don't interrupt.
I'm focused. I'm driven. Here I am.
To build a dam.
Boy.
I guess.
That was funny.
I mean, I do have a romantic type, but it's not a fun one. It's kind of sad. Wonder you're bored. Okay, so let's go and... Okay, so on page 79... They ask you and your spouse, and before that, there's a ton of different ideas of things you can do. But on page 79, they ask the husband and the wife to each name 10 things that are free that express love to me. So things that you can just do without much money. And so I don't know if we can come up with 10 things.
Do you want me to give you five, and then you give me five?
Yeah, but you're going to steal all my five.
You want to go first?
You go first, and I'll... But I'm going to say, I want that one.
Okay. Well, and we can have the same. And obviously, we've been married 33 years, so there's going to be some that are the same.
Okay.
I think these are what is the ways that you express love, right?
10 free things that express love to me.
Okay. Go on walks together, whether it's along the canyon or whatever. Go drive somewhere, spend some time together. Just even going on a road trip. That's fun.
I like his answers.
Watch Hallmark movies together. I know I said I was forced to watch them growing up. Well, not forced. I can't say forced. Because my mom's going to watch this video and she's going to be like, I never forced you to watch Hallmark movies.
No, he loves them. He just doesn't want to admit it.
Yeah, there you go.
To the public.
Correct. But... Now they know. So anyway, watch those movies, cook a special meal.
Mm.
So, or go out to dinner together.
Mm-hmm. It has to be free. These are 10 free things.
Okay, so cook
pretty free.
Cook a nice meal here at home, and we enjoy that experience with each other together, having a nice meal.
Okay.
What else?
I'm liking it.
Just even go into Sun Valley.
Yeah.
Driving to Sun Valley and sitting by the river. We've mentioned that several times on other videos. Yeah.
We've done that often where we just grab some ice cream out of the little sea store and then took our little chairs and sat by the river.
Yep.
We've done that often.
So that's my...
That's your five right now?
Six, seven, eight. I don't know. It was quite a few. Well, but what about you?
You had a lot of the ones I would do. So luckily we like the same things.
Do you have any other ones?
Maybe go to ice cream. It's not free, but we like to just go get an ice cream.
Ice cream's cheap.
Yeah. Like it's real inexpensive. At like 31 Flavors or something.
Baskin Robbins. Yep. What else?
Oh, man. I thought of some while you were talking, and then I got into what you were saying.
That's okay.
Oh, a picnic. picnic. You could always take me on a picnic.
She has been after me to take her on a picnic for I don't know how long. I just need to do that this coming year. 2022 is the year of the picnic.
It's too cold for a picnic right now. But we can always do a picnic on the front room floor.
Sure.
That's totally free.
Sure.
I do love to go on a drive. Sometimes we like to just go and look at other people's yards and houses in the spring. And
Landscaping. We like to go to the landscaping show.
Yep. And that's not always free. It's a couple bucks to get in. But
it's cheap, though. I mean, it's not like it's an arm and a leg to get in. It's like $2 a person. It's just really affordable fun.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, you get to go see all the latest and greatest technology for all of yard stuff and building and just a lot of fun things.
But yeah, like a lot of the same stuff. I did think of one other thing and then it's gone, but I'll think of it later.
Okay.
But maybe they can actually in the comments. Can you guys remind us of some other free stuff for other couples and what do you love to do? It all depends on your personality and what you love to do together. We've even gone to Barnes & Noble and gotten a coffee and then walked through the bookstore.
We just looked around.
Yeah.
Yeah. We do that too. That's always an option.
Yep. Or go people watching. We are really, really lucky that down just 5 minutes from our house is a big bridge that people do base jumping off of.
Yep.
And it's one of the only places in the world that allows you to just jump off the bridge.
Yeah. With a parachute.
With a parachute. And you don't have to be permitted, I don't think. Or maybe they have to.
You have to have X amount of jump hours to jump by yourself, but they do have tandem jumping, which you can pay a professional jumper. They just strap you to them and then they jump and pull the chute. And then you can, once you get X amount of jumps in under your belt, then you can jump yourself.
Yeah. So
you get certified.
You can, people come from all over the world. So when we go down there and we're up by the visitor center, there's all the people folding up their parachutes and getting ready for the next jump. And I mean, there's people from Australia, England.
Just everywhere. Everywhere.
Just everywhere. You'll run into people from all different walks of life.
Yep.
And so that's fun too. And that's along our kind of a boardwalk. It's not really a boardwalk, but it's the walking trail.
It's kind of. It's along the walking trail.
On the canyon.
On the Snake River Canyon edge. So,
yeah. So, taking a walk. I like to hike.
Hiking is good. We did Ross Falls, you guys saw that video where we went, took Duchess with us to Ross Falls. Yeah. That was fun.
Just go out for the day. So those are romantic to me, I think. They're pretty romantic.
So you're saying then you're true blue romantic then?
Well, true blue was I am a true blue. I'm a type four lover, true blue. And we think you're kind of a... You had a mix, but we think you're more the hopeless romantic.
Or Wind Beneath My Wings.
Wind Beneath My Wings.
No, hopeless romantic. Never mind.
Yeah.
I thought you were that one.
You can find these in the book on page 71, 72, 73, and 74. And those are fun to take. Okay, another one. I have. Okay. 10 dream dates. His and hers. We can even go back and forth.
Anniversary Inn
is pretty fun.
Except for when you're sick.
Oh. Yeah, that wasn't good.
Yeah, you were sick that one time. That was terrible. You had a fever. You were thoroughly sick.
And we were in this room. Oh,
talk about romance. Yeah, baby. Would you like me to go get you some more soup?
We were waiting and I couldn't stop. I had pile of tissues.
Oh, that was terrible. That was probably one of the worst times we've ever had. But, I mean, I got to take care of you.
The sad part is it had been years since we'd been able to go and do anything.
And just get away.
And I shut down the shop. We cleared our schedule. I think we even had kids at that point. I'm not sure.
Oh, yeah.
Or maybe.
Oh,
and we, you know, arranged them to be taken care of. Yep. I mean, everything.
Yep.
And I wasn't sick when we left our house, But somehow, by the time we traveled like a couple hours,
by the time we got there and we got in the room, you were all toughy and and it was like, what is happening? There's no romance in this anymore.
And I had the shivers. And the worst part was, is that, oh my gosh, comedy in this. The worst part is we were in the room. It was like a down under. So there were fish tanks everywhere. So they do themed rooms.
Yep.
And there were fish tanks everywhere. And I was stuck in the room for like 2 or 3 days, like just shivering. And I swear the fish were staring at me, and I started to get really upset because the fish wouldn't let me alone. Oh, it's bad.
Oh, my God.
Okay, so
oh my God.
That's your dream date.
Not that one.
Okay, another dream date. I'll try to think of some, too.
And no, it's your turn to pick one.
Oh, gosh.
I just did one. You said we're going to go back.
Oh, and this is a dream date, so I could be anywhere and anything. I'd love to go somewhere tropical and warm right now.
Yeah, that would be good.
We have never gotten to just go to Hawaii. We wanted to do it for our honeymoon. And then we were poor little 19-year-olds that had no money. And
I'm kind of glad that we don't have the money to go to Hawaii, because 5 hours on a plane, and I'm claustrophobic, that would not go over well. I would be clawing the seats.
Okay.
After so first couple maybe hours.
not Hawaii, but
just somewhere nice along the coast would be great.
Now, what we do love, and we've been there quite a few times, is the coast of California along PCH.
Cambria.
Right? Yep, Cambria, California is probably one of our favorites, because you basically are staying in the hotels right. You basically step out, cross the little street, and yep. You are at the beach.
Yeah.
And it has an adorable little town.
It's a cool location. Yep. It's a cool area.
And then all the way up through there. What's another? We haven't dreamed in a long time.
What are your dream dates? Maybe go stay in a cabin.
That would be fun.
Stay in a cabin somewhere. You know, one of those hostels where you can just go rent, or not a hostel. What is it called? It's not a bed and breakfast. It's an Airbnb.
Okay.
Where you can go spend the weekend at someone's cabin that they're renting.
That'd be really fun. There's some really cool Airbnbs around that are unique little places. You can stay in a treehouse. You can stay in...
I don't know about a treehouse.
Really? I think a treehouse would be really cool.
You sleepwalk, you fall. It's not a pretty situation.
Are you planning on sleepwalking?
You never know.
Yeah. I don't know. We might need a little bit more ideas and a little bit more help we have been married 33 years. We need to rev up this romance. So if you guys can help us in the comments, tell us where to go.
Yeah. Yeah.
What to do. Okay. So I have some other questions to wrap up this chapter, which it just has, you guys have to go through the chapter. It has 25 free or nearly free ideas at the back, and lots of ideas, lots of paragraphs about different ways. You could always do...
Are you going to ask those ones?
Okay. Yeah. To finish up this, we will ask these.
Okay.
Try a few of these questions to fan the flame of your love. Are you guys ready? Number one, we have to both answer it.
Okay.
If someone were to write a book about our love, what would you title it?
War and Peace.
Just War and Peace.
Just saying.
You know what? I'm going to go with that.
You have fights and you make up. And then you have peace. It's marriage. It's what it's all about.
Yeah.
That's just it.
I'm going to go with his title because that's just too good.
All right. What's the second one?
Okay. Number two.
Here we go.
If I put my hands over your eyes and said, surprise, what would you want to see when you opened your eyes?
Let's just put censored on that one.
You're not allowed to say on national.
On YouTube? No.
On a public forum.
No. Because I don't want our channel to get turned off. I'm just going to say.
Okay.
What's the third one?
Wait, I get to answer the question.
You
go for it. So if you were to put your hands over, you're not going to believe what I would say.
This ought to be good. Go ahead.
A clean house. I really love it. It makes me feel relaxed and just love it.
That's exciting. You've got to be kidding me.
You guys, we are in trouble.
Oh, boy.
We are in trouble deep. Help us.
A clean house.
Oh, I,
cover your eyes. That, take your hands off your eyes.
I was being honest, and that's the very first thing that popped into my head. And I can't think of anything else past the clean house.
Okay.
I'm sure there's other things, you know, that would be great.
I'm sure everybody else will have plenty of comments on other things.
Please tell us. Give us ideas.
Okay, let's hear the next
one. Okay. What am I on? Number three?
Three.
If we were to rendezvous any place on Earth, where would you want to go and why? So rendezvous means like we don't go together, we rendezvous. Well, first of all, here's a weird tip about me. I don't drive outside of my own city. So I can't even meet him. He'd be waiting forever.
Oh my God.
That's too much information.
That's
but
too funny.
I'm a little bit weird that way.
If, let's just say, if she drove.
Okay.
I would say along the coast.
Yes.
I'd meet you at an undisclosed location. You would have to just start driving. I could give you directions to a certain point and then tell you the rest of the directions you're needing to get to where I'm at.
I just had another thought too.
I would have to say one of those.
I've always wanted to go on one of those trips that sees all the fall foliage in the East Coast.
Oh, to Boston and back east.
Yeah.
Maine, Vermont.
Yeah. But I wouldn't want a rendezvous there because that means I'd have to drive there.
Well, and plus when it's fall leaves, it's going to be cold. So you really weren't going to want to be outside a lot. So we'd have to do an Airbnb, plus you could look out their windows at the Airbnb and see all the pretty leaves and go, oh, those are beautiful. I'm so glad we just drove 4 days to get here.
Yeah. Well, I can see us in a nice little sweater with a little scarf and apple.
What?
And apple picking.
A sweater?
For fall leaves.
What's wrong with a coat?
Well, that's not movie-esque.
Oh. We have to go back to the 50s with a cardigan. Should I have a pipe?
Yes, please. Okay. I got it.
Go ahead.
Okay, number four. What kind of car describes me best? This is so funny because we have the cars that describe us best.
So your Scion is your perfect vehicle.
Practical.
Well, it's so tiny.
It's tiny.
I mean, she could literally park in the street, and if you had to do a U-turn, you could literally just turn your wheel and go,
yep,
and go down the street and start heading
there. And I can pack anything I want in the back, including an entire apartment. I've helped my daughter move up when she moved to college, and we fit
everything
pretty much her whole apartment in the back of my car.
Yeah.
Even though it's tiny, it's like spacious. It's practical.
It's the perfect car for you.
I have the car that describes me.
Yeah. And so do I.
What is your car?
350Z.
Royal blue.
Yep. My favorite color.
Low.
Sleek.
Fast.
Yep.
Yep. And doesn't do well in the snow.
But it doesn't need to, because I drive her car.
And you can't
in
buy
the snow.
And you can't buy groceries and put it in the car.
You can. My car fits two golf bags in the back. If you watch the instruction sheet that's stuck to the sticker to the top of the hatch when you open it, it tells you exactly how to position the golf bags so you can fit two.
Okay,
so not that I golf.
So I have a question. When you want to go run errands, whose car do you grab?
Yours.
Why?
Because I'd rather put miles on yours than mine.
It was because it was more practical.
No. If I want to just go drive around and just to go drive to get just to go clear my head or whatever, I'll take my car.
Okay.
Just to go like to Boise and back or whatever.
Okay.
I'd take mine.
You drive yours for joy.
Correct.
And mine...
For practicality, yes.
For practicality.
Correct.
Okay.
And groceries. And errands.
Now, what car do I want to be?
Ooh, that's a good question. Is that what it says?
No, I'm just making that up.
Oh, well, what car would I like to be? What car, if you had all the money in the world, what car would you rather have?
Not that I'd rather have it.
What car would you rather be? If you were able to get the car you really like, what would it be?
Without any practical ties or anything.
No practical ties.
A Mustang.
I like that answer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got to be able to fit groceries, though.
Mustangs have a pretty big trunk.
And I now think Mustangs have a little too much power for me in the snow.
You'd probably get tickets. I could see you getting tickets.
Okay, one last question, and then we'll wrap up this video and let you all go answer your own questions.
Here we go.
Okay, ready? What's been the nicest surprise of being married to me? Oh, that was a nice question. Wait, I have to think.
I have three words.
We should have read these ahead of time.
I have three words. Your love for me, your compassion for me, and your faithfulness to me.
I love that.
Those three.
Well, ironically, yours is that you get me out of my box, you shake things up, and you make life exciting. And you love me.
Those are good four.
Yeah, because
sometimes you get bored in your own box.
Yeah.
If you don't ever get out of your box, your comfort zone, you can't really experience life.
Yeah, I think I'm too regimented that I probably would bore myself to death.
Yeah.
And I would have never got past the schedule. And now I actually am taking on some of your personalities. Maybe that's why when we're out driving, I'm like, turn down that road. Let's go see what's over there.
That could be.
It could be that it's not so much my personality, but I'm starting to change to be more like you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I could see that.
And I can see you being more regimented.
Yeah. It's like because of the older we get, the more we're actually switching, which is bizarre.
Mm-hmm.
It is very bizarre. But yeah.
Yeah. So, some fun things to talk about with your spouse.
Yeah.
It's a really good chapter. Make sure you grab your book. Like waffles, women are like spaghetti.
Yep.
You might be able to even find it online, maybe even on Google, that you can maybe go ahead and find those little questionnaires. But they were super fun to ask your spouse.
Yeah.
So, with that, we're going to go get ready to go to a wedding. This man's getting dressed up.
Until next time, Jay, Krista, say adieu forever.
We'll see you later. Love you guys.